I just want to start this video by showing off. Today, what I thought we would do is to learn the numbers in Kinyarwanda from 1 to 10. Now, I speak Kinyarwanda with a very British accent or a very foreign accent. So what I've done is I've roped my friend Claudine into helping. So she's going to go through the numbers with us, and that way you can hear a Rwandan accent and how things should be pronounced. So unfortunately, we had a slight hiccup because her microphone didn't work and we were contending with a really loud bird in the garden. So there's a couple of numbers that get a little bit squawked over, but hopefully it's enough to hear by. So what's going to happen is Claudine's going to go through each number, and after each number, I'm going to explain how I remember that number or how I try to remember that number. Now, Kinyarwanda is a Bantu language, very localized to Rwanda. And Bantu languages are unlike any European language. So, you know, most European languages are Latin-based or kind of Germanic-based. They all sort of share a lot of common root words and sounds. But in Kinyarwanda, the sounds are often very different, and it's very hard to try to link those to something that you already know. But I do my best, is I try to link Kinyarwanda words two words that I know in English, and sometimes that gives my brain a little bit of a memory boost and just kicks in to help me to remember things. So I will share what I use with you. Sometimes the way that I get there is a little bit odd, but you know, it works, and that's the important thing, is whatever works for you. So let's go.
Rimge, rimge, rimge.
Okay, so limwe, the number one. Basically, the way that I remember this one is I put my hand in the air. Is I put one limb in the air, one limb way up in the air. So limwe, limb way up in the air. Yeah, not sophisticated, but it works. So limwe, one, and it looks like the number one because it's just it's your limb way up in the air looking like a number one.
Kabiri, kabiri, kabiri.
So kabiri I remember as the Roman numeral for two because it's got the double I, kabiri. So if you put those two I's together, it looks like the Roman numeral two, kabiri. Again, not an easy one.
Gatatu, gatatu, gatatu.
Gatatu is three, and I'm going to come back to talk about this in a moment because it links in with another number and it makes it easier to remember.
Kane, kane, kane.
Kane, I remember because it's the number four, and kane has four letters in it. So the number with four letters is the number four.
Gatanu, gatanu, gatanu.
Gatanu is the number five. Now in Rwanda, we tend to show the number five with a closed fist, whereas in the UK and many English-speaking countries, we show five with the open fist. But here it's gatanu, the number five. It's also the name of a popular beer. But the way that you can remember this, gatatu with the T is three. Gatanu without the three is five. So if it's gatatu and it's a T, it's a three. If it's gatanu, nu three, nu three, it's five.
Gatandatu, gatandatu, gatandatu.
So the number six, gatandatu, is not an easy one to remember because it's long. It doesn't kind of roll off the tongue very easily. Gatandatu. The sort of the beginning of it, gata and gatatu, gatandatu, it sounds a lot like three, but longer. So it's like three plus three. It's longer, but it's also six. That's a really convoluted way of getting there. I know, I'm afraid I can't be much more help there, but gatandatu, it sounds a little bit like gatatu, only longer. And therefore, it's two times three, six. Yeah, sorry. I got nothing else for you on that one.
Karindwi, karindwi, karindwi.
Karindwe, the number seven. So the way that I remember this is extremely culturally specific. So I lived in Wales for a while. I went to university in Wales and I love folklore. And in Welsh folklore, there's an old crone with a magic cauldron called Caridwen. And Caridwen, she stirs her cauldron. And so in my mind, Karindwi sounds like Caridwen, and I just imagine her stirring a number seven into the pot like this. So Caridwen, Karindwe. It's really culturally specific, and that maybe only works for me and Welsh people. So I don't know. Whatever gets you there gets you there.
Umunani, umunani, umunani.
Umunani, the number eight. I don't really have anything for you. I love the way it sounds, umunani. It's got a lovely kind of umunani. It kind of trips off the tongue. I like it. But I don't really have an easy way to remember that one.
Ichenda, ichenda, ichenda.
Again, number nine, ichenda. I don't really have a way to remember that one, ichenda. Some of these you just have to find your own way or just remember it by rote, ichenda. If you've got a good way of remembering it, let me know below.
Ichumi, ichumi, ichumi.
Ichumi, finally we're at number 10. Now, the way that I remember this is a little bit cheeky. It's kind of, you know in The Simpsons where Bart gets really annoyed and he just says, bite me? With ichumi, I kind of feel like bite me, it's like chew me, chew on me, mic drop, I got to the end. You know, it's like chew me, chew on this. You know, it's that's the only way I can really think through it. My brain works in mysterious ways that I have never really understood. But that's how I get through it. So let me know if you've got a better connection or a better way of remembering it, and let me know below because I'm sure it would help a lot of people. So together, limwe, kabiri, gatatu, kani, gatanu, gatandatu, karindwe, umanani, ichenda, ichumi.
Rimwe, kabiri, gatatu, kane, gatanu, gatandatu, karindwi, umunani, ichenda, ichumi. Rimwe, kabiri, gatatu, kane, gatanu, gatandatu, karindwi, umunani, ichenda, ichumi.